Torsion is a family business. That was my father and my uncle who started the business in the 1920s. And when they came from Moscow after the Russian Revolution, they found out that with all this Russian nobility, they still had money.
Yes.
But they had no caviar. So they decided to call Moscow. And I met the person who took the phone in Moscow, in the Ministry of Foreign Trade, at the time. So she took the phone and finally somebody came and said, all right, we want to buy some caviar from you. The only way to pay is to bring the money to the Russian mission. They knocked at the door with a little suitcase in the hand. Everybody started around the table to count the money. And 3 months later, they received the goods. Immediately in Paris, around the Russian community here, everybody heard that it was caviar. Caviar has arrived in Paris, and everybody came to buy the caviar. Good help came from Kurnowski, Prince des Gastronomes, and caviar was for him the fabulous dream. Cesar, at the time, helped a lot. Gave an advice to my parents. He said, look, you know, you are a very nice gentleman. Really, we appreciate you very much. For you, we will put the caviar in our restaurants. But let me give you an advice. You know, caviar is not for future. You will never make, you know. It's an art to prepare caviar. It's not only that you must have the right fish, the right sea. 95% of the caviar consumed in the world comes from the Caspian Sea. Why? First of all, it's a closed sea. Second of all, you have the right species of sturgeon. You have three species, beluga, which is the biggest fish, osetra, and sevruga. You find in the Caspian Sea the right food, the right temperature of the water, the right degree of salinity of the water.
Yes.
And it's a little bit like cognac, like wine. It's not allowed in Russia to catch the fish in the sea. They have to catch it when they come back, when they are ready to come back to spawn. Because in the sea you can catch the sturgeons which are not ready. On the three quarters of the arm of the river, put the net, the sturgeons come inside and they bring the net to the shore, they take the sturgeons and they put them in barges with water inside, which communicate with the river. So the sturgeon will not be stressed. Because if the sturgeon is stressed, then it will release on the eggs some acidity. And that's not good for the caviar. It should not suffer, it should be very, very quiet. And it's a very dull fish. You have a spot behind the head where it's very sensitive. If you hit this right spot, the sturgeon goes to sleep. The preparation of caviar is complex but quick.
Yes.
So you open, you take the eggs out of the sturgeon and then hand it to the master. The master, they add salt. After that, it goes to a sieve to drop all the waters. And after that, really, they pack it. So the whole process, 15, 20 minutes. So now, you have big rooms. On each room, you have the tins.
Yes.
And each line of tin comes from one sturgeon. You must know that the sturgeon gives approximately 10 to 12% of his own weight in caviar. So a beluga, which weighs 300, 350 kilos, will give like
35, 40 kilos
of caviar. They are put in two kilo tins, and all these tins are on one line. So I choose the first tin of each line. I accept or I reject the whole line.
That sounds like a very bad job to have.
Tough.